Looking for a storage solution for your computer? Well, in this video, I'm going to discuss three popular storage methods and their pros, cons, price, and help you decide which one is best for you. Even though you'll mainly see Macs in this video, these storage options work perfectly with PCs as well. Let's introduce our contenders, shall we? Starting with the cheapest and easiest storage solution, we have the trusty hard drive. Cheap, slow, with a large capacity, you're already probably pretty familiar with this, but maybe not our next option, which is an SSD. SSD stands for solid state drive, and its huge advantage over traditional hard drives is its speed. However, its capacity is usually more limited due to the more expensive pricing compared to hard drives, and this brings us to our final option, which is a NAS or network attached storage. This bad boy can hold tens of terabytes of data and is great for data hoarders or simply those who want to consolidate a whole bunch of hard drives into one place. We'll examine these options in greater detail, but first, a quick word from our sponsor. Worried about your child's or your cat's internet safety? FamiSafe is a powerful and full-featured parental control app for families. It lets parents control screen time, track real-time location, block certain apps, and detect inappropriate content on kids' devices. It's cross-platform, so you can control an iOS device from an Android phone, for example, and it's available on Windows, Mac, Android, iOS, and Kindle devices. Click the link in the description to try a 3-day free trial now. Let's break this video down into sections. Starting with speed, it's no surprise that your typical hard drive is going to be quite slow, with a read and write speed of around 100 megabytes per second. This is because the hard drive is an actual magnetic disk with a spindle head mechanically moving around and reading data. Think of it like a record player. Hard drives have been around for a long time and they're old technology, which means you can buy high capacity drives for very cheap. However, the problem is that they're very sensitive to movement and external conditions like heat, and are very slow to read or write large amounts of data. Again, due to them having moving parts. This is where SSDs come in. Like the name suggests, they are solid-state drives. There are no moving parts. This results in vastly increased speed and the ability to resist vibrations and movement. Take a look at just how fast they are in this graph. Even an entry-level budget SSD blows your typical hard drive out of the water, and the great part about SSDs is there are lots of different options. You can get a budget SSD with fairly good speeds, or go all out on a premium one which is just as fast as the internal SSD on the latest MacBooks. Or you can even make your own. Check out the video I made on this in the top right corner. SSDs are perfect for transferring large amounts of data quickly, or even storing high-resolution video footage on to edit in real time off the SSD itself. So where does a NAS fit into all this? If you're the type of person to download and store movies, or you take a lot of videos and photos on each vacation and want to keep all that data in one place, for example, a NAS is perfect. A NAS is essentially an enclosure containing multiple hard drives linked together via software. You can connect it to your computer using either a network cable or via a Wi-Fi network. You can scale its capacity and speed up and down too. Most NAS setups are built for high storage capacity and are often relatively slow, around 100 megabytes per second, but you can configure it to be super fast as well, up to 1000 megabytes per second with the right parts. My current NAS is from Synology and I have a 10 gigabit Ethernet network card inside, allowing me to get a consistent 500 to 600 megabytes per second read and write speed. This allows me to keep all of my high quality video footage on my NAS and edit directly from it. Let's move on to storage capacity. Starting with hard drives, you can get anything from 500 megabytes up to 16 terabytes. There are a lot of different capacity options, and the larger the drive capacity is, the lower the price per gigabyte is. SSDs are a little different. Generally, the capacity is smaller, so they often start around 250 megabytes and usually go up to around 4 terabytes. You won't find many people using 4 terabyte or larger external SSDs because of the price, but they do exist. Now, a NAS is unique in that you can usually start a NAS at the smallest possible size, say 2 terabytes. But you're also able to simply add additional drives to the NAS to increase storage or swap out existing drives for higher capacity drives. I'm using a 6-bay Synology NAS, which I've linked down in the description, by the way, which means I could have up to 80 terabytes of storage space if I wanted by using 6 16 terabyte NAS hard drives. The total storage available depends on your choice of RAID, but I'll cover that in a different video. There are also many different NAS enclosure options. You can get 2, 4, 6, or 8 bay NASes, or even large server-level NASes with tens of drives within them. So what about pricing? Well, as we've discussed previously, hard drives are very cheap. Smaller capacity hard drives are going to cost you next to nothing, while the larger capacity drives, such as 4, 8, or even 16 terabytes, are more expensive, but still much cheaper compared to SSDs. SSDs can start at the budget level, like the Samsung T5, and go all the way up to a Sabrent Rocket XTRM Thunderbolt 3, and there are a lot of options in between, so you have a lot of choice. A NAS is similar. A very basic NAS setup could be as simple as a 2-bay enclosure with 2 moderate capacity hard drives, all the way up to a specced out 8-bay NAS with 8 16-terabyte hard drives, 32GB of RAM, and a 10Gigabit Ethernet network card. This allows you to scale the price to your exact needs and budget. Let's also briefly mention portability. Small capacity hard drives are relatively small and portable, but like I said before, they don't like to be moved or knocked or exposed to vibrations. Once you start getting to 4 terabytes and above, the physical size becomes very large and portability decreases drastically. SSDs, on the other hand, are often very small and can be easily stored in a pocket or card sleeve in a bag. You can even Velcro it to the back of your laptop screen and use it on the go. A NAS is, unfortunately, not very portable at all. However, depending on the physical size, can still be moved with relative ease if you need to move it to another location, for example. Just know that it needs to be fully powered down before you move it. So, which storage solution should you choose? I recommend the hard drive if you're after a cheap, simple way to expand your storage, and you'll be using it mostly to store data on at home. Don't get a hard drive if you need it to be portable, or you intend to regularly read or write large files to it, such as video footage from a camera, and speed is also a factor. I recommend an SSD if you want to be able to take it almost anywhere, such as work or school. SSDs are usually very small and portable, and even come in rugged configurations if you require. The fact that they have no moving parts means you can even leave it hanging from its cable while connected to your computer. Their prices are also usually quite affordable, especially if you don't need the blazing fast speeds of the premium models. For example, the 1TB Samsung T5 is only around $120, much less if you can get it on sale. I recommend a NAS if your total storage requirement is over 4TB. Once you start getting to this amount of data, it's much safer and economical to use a NAS. You can easily expand storage in the future if you require, and it also adds the option to store your data safely. What do I mean by this? Well, if you're the type of person to store your data on a single hard drive, if that drive fails, you lose everything. With a NAS, you can set up a RAID configuration that will spread the data across one or more drives, so if one drive in your NAS fails, you still have all of your data intact. If you're interested in a specific video on my Synology NAS that allows me to edit high quality 4K and 6K footage in real time, comment down below and let me know. But apart from that, thanks for watching this video, and I'll catch you in the next one.